Hey everyone, I'm glad to present our paper named Efficient Improper Learning for Online Logistic Regression. So we are interested in an online learning framework where the input and output arrive sequentially. So the input are vectors with dimension d and L2 norm bounded by r. The learner predicts real and the environment reveals an output yt, which is binary, minus 1 or 1. So we make no assumption on how are generated the input and output, and they can be chosen by an adversary who knows all the previous predictions of the learner. So to assess the performance of the learner, we use the logistic loss, and the goal is to minimize the cumulative regret, which is the difference between the cumulative loss of the learner and the cumulative loss of the best function taken in a comparator class of function, so, which is here the linear function with L2 norm bounded by B. So if I rephrase, the goal is to predict as well as the best linear function with L2 norm bounded by B. So to achieve such a goal, one can use classical algorithms from the theory of online covariate optimization. So if we make the observation that the logistic loss is convex and Lie-Chips, online gradient descent will have a regret bounded by b square root n. So I'm recalling that b is the bound over the on the L2 norm of the linear function we compare to, and n is the number of samples. So because the logistic loss is also Epps concave, we can use online Newton step, which will achieve a logarithmic regret. Because the logistic loss is only exponential minus b Epps concave, we will pay exponential multiplicative constant in B. So you see that the online Newton step algorithm improves exponentially the dependence in N, but deteriorates exponentially the dependence in B. So one can ask if it's possible to have the best of the two algorithms, so to achieve logarithmic regret without exponential constant. And if I'm reframing this goal, and ask, is it possible to achieve polylogarithmic regret in the regime when b equal log n? Indeed, the online gradient descent doesn't have polylogarithmic regret, and in the regime when b equal log n, the online Newton step algorithm doesn't have also polylogarithmic regret. So it's a particularly interesting question because Hazan and co-authors have shown in 2014 that any proper algorithm which suffers logarithmic regret will have exponential multiplicative constant. So what is a proper algorithm? It's an algorithm with a prediction function which belongs to the comparator class of function. So here a proper algorithm will be just an algorithm with a prediction function which is linear. So we have shown a lower bound which is polynomial over lower bound the regret which is polynomial for any algorithm with a linear prediction function. But this lower bound doesn't apply to improper algorithm because Foster and co-authors have shown that an improper algorithm can achieve a regret bounded by d log bn. So a statistical performance which is unattainable by any proper algorithm. To do it, they made the observation that the logistic loss is one mixable compared to exponential minus b Epps concave, and they use the Vovk aggregating algorithm. However, in this algorithm, they need to sample from log concave distribution, which is possible to do in polynomial time with MCMC method, but it's not really computationally practical. So it left open the question to achieve the same kind of statistical performance, but with much more practical algorithm. So the main contribution of our paper is to propose a new algorithm, the regret bounded by DB log BN, so a regret that can't be achieved by any proper algorithm, but with a computational complexity, which is n times D2 plus log n, so much more practical than the algorithm of Foster and Coauthors, and which is close to the one of online Newton step, for example. So before defining our algorithm, I need to recall some key parts of the analysis of online Newton step. So online Newton step relies on quadratic approximation of the loss, and the main hypothesis that we need to do to show logarithmic regret is that this quadratic approximation are lower bound of the true loss. And for example, any alpha exconcave loss verify this hypothesis if we take eta accordingly. So if this hypothesis is verified, we can show that the online Newton step algorithm suffered regret bounded by log n, but with a multiplicative constant which is proportional to 1 over eta. And in the case of the logistic cost, 1 over eta will be of the order of exponential b. However, we can make the observation that, in fact, the logistic loss is only exponential minus b exconcave only when y theta dot x is close to minus b. With that is because eta is closely related to the ratio of the square of the gradient over variation, because this quadratic approximation are almost Taylor approximation, but we replace the Hessian by Taylor by the outer product of the gradient. And this ratio is big on the left side of this graph and much smaller on the over part. So we can think that constant eta can be much better when y theta dot x is bigger than minus b. So if I make this statement more precise, and so if now we make eta depends on theta 2, we can show the following inequality. So if eta is equal to exponential y theta 2 dot xt over 1 plus br, the inequality is true. And we can see that eta, so of course in the worst case will be of the order of exponential minus b, but if y theta 2 dot xt is bigger than minus b, then this eta value can be much bigger. So because in the worst case the eta can value is close to exponential minus b, this idea alone is not enough to remove exponential multiplicative constants. This is why we use a second idea, which is we call improper regularization. So now we can state the proposed algorithm. So our estimator is a minimum of a convex function composed to the sum of the quadratic approximation of the previous loss. So here L hat is the quadratic approximation of the logistic loss, plus two terms which correspond to two possible losses at instant t for the two possible outputs, minus one and one. Then we predict theta hat t dot xt, but it's important to remark that this prediction function is not linear because theta hat t depends on xt. And it's possible to see that experimentally on the graph. So our algorithm in orange doesn't have a linear prediction function, partout, for example, follow the regularized leader. So the main result of our paper is to show a bound on the regret of this algorithm, which is logarithmic in the number of samples, but doesn't have exponential multiplicative constant. And in fact, the dependency in B is near to linear. So I won't enter into the details of the proof, but just to give an idea why combining the two previous ideas is good to remove the exponential constants. There is essentially two cases. So the case where yt theta hat t.xt is much smaller than zero, then theta will be the order of exponential minus b, but because our estimator is close to an oracle prediction function, thanks to the improper regularization, we can manage to bound the regret. And in the other case, eta, which now depends on theta hat t, will be much bigger than exponential minus b, and so we won't pay exponential constant. So to support our theoretical results, we have also some experiments in the setting of in the IID setting, which is the same that has been used to show the lower bound of Hazen and Clotaire in the regime when b equal log n. So we can see that proper algorithm like follow the regularized leader has indeed a polynomial regret, and the algorithm of Foster and Clotaire has a logarithmic regret, maybe smaller, and our algorithm achieve log n square regret. So our algorithm is designed for the online setting, but with online to batch conversion, we can make it suitable for the batch setting, and we will have some bound on the excess risk in expectation. So we can compare our result now to overworks in the ISD setting. So for example, there is work that analyze empirical risk minimization, and they show that with some additional assumption, they can show that they achieve logarithmic regret without exponential constant. But they need this this additional assumption, because if not, the lower bound of Hazen would have applied. And there is also a recent work which has also an improper algorithm, and they have shown that the regret is bounded by D plus B2, so it's a bound close to ours. Of course, there is no the logarithmic dependence in N because it's a batch setting, but they have a polynomial dependence in B. So to conclude, in this paper, we introduce a new algorithm which achieves logarithmic regret that is not suffering from exponential multiplicative constant. But compared to the algorithm of Foster and Clotaire, this new algorithm is much more practical. So we left as open question if it's possible to show high probability bound in the IID setting for algorithm, and if it's possible to generalize to multi-class learning. So thanks for watching, and see you for the questions.